Now, throughout the lecture, I emphasize one point is that you have to stop and reflect. Okay? Stop from what you're doing. Just meditate and reflect. Ask yourself, who am I? What am I doing here? What's really important to me? Don't wait until strategy strikes, then you start thinking. When people say, oh, I rethink my life. I reevaluate my life. I discover the purpose of my life after they got very sick or after tragic happened to their loved ones. But you don't have to wait until tragedy strikes. Right? You should be able to engage in self-reflection on those important questions that affect your future. So you gotta know who you are, what you're doing, what you love doing, and why you love what you do. And those reflections are important for you to become fully human. Because only humans reflect, right? Monkeys don't reflect. Dogs don't reflect. Robots don't reflect. See, this capacity for self-reflection, say Buddhists emphasize meditation, right? And meditation is time to look inward and reflect. Now, there's another way to look at being fully human. Now, Maslow is a very famous humanist psychologist. Now, he said, well, in the beginning, we're all concerned about biological needs, survival needs, food, shelter, and then we talk about psychological needs, such as esteem, relationship, loving people, being loved, and then we have self-actualization, means that you're able to fulfill your potential and realize your dreams. But finally, what? Add one more point: self-transcendence, where when you're fully developed, you go beyond self to reach out to the bigger reality, higher reality of loving humanity, loving God. You're able to transcend your self-interest. That's the higher development. So to be fully developed, to be fully functioning, is to reach the highest level of self-transcendence. Yes?
But I would argue that this is not necessarily a hierarchy, that you can be doing all those things simultaneously. You don't have to wait
before
you get to the next level.
So these are ideas about development. Doesn't mean they have one for another, all right? It's possible for you to, there are people who are poor, whose basic need is not met, they're still able to achieve self-transcendence, right? There are many poor monks who don't owe anything, right? There are people who are suffering, physical suffering, they're still able to achieve, you know, this is in terms of hierarchy, in terms of value, rather than step by step, yeah. So you can skip the early one. You can still achieve the highest value. The highest value is self-transcendence. That is this one you are fully human. There's another word by Irish poet, saying that the world is full of magic things waiting patiently for us, for our senses to grow sharper. He is saying that. You will live in a cave, right? We do not know the beauty outside the cave. Most of them are blind. I remember one movie about a Japanese bureaucrat. He every day go to work, you know, busy worker. The movie is called Akio. So one day, when he's 50 years old, he discovered he had terminal cancer. Then he realized that his life is going to end. I said, I better find a way to really live happily before I die. And then he caught a bridge, he looked at sunset, he transfixed at the beauty. But every day he passed by the bridge, every day, go to work, he saw nothing. And all of a sudden, his eyes were opened. The world for beauty is so beautiful. His eyes are open. he finally got out of the cave. After he learned about the bad news of dying, so let's don't wait until that moment. And here, same idea. Oh, you find purpose after tragedy. After tragedy, man, don't wait until tragedy happens. Why can't you evaluate your life now? You know, reassess your life now. Don't wait until tragedy happens. And here, don't run away from pain. Don't run with tears. Be open to all the experiences. All the experiences make us stronger. See, then you're not afraid of anymore. The more you feel pain, the more you suffer, right? See, pain is physical. Suffering is psychological. Both psychology and Buddhism all teach that you can make your pain more worse if you worry about that. The psychology is a gate theory. But if you are relaxed about it and not to worry too much about pain, you feel less pain. So here the natural way for it. A happy life is not a life free from pain, free from tears, but a life where you fully embrace tears and pain. And when you make detour, that's fine, we all make mistakes. The key is going back to the right path, right? We embrace life in totality, good and bad, they're all connected.